Hi, it's Jamie, Progressive number one, number two employee. Leave a message at the... Hey, Jamie, it's me, Jamie. This is your daily pep talk. I know it's been rough going ever since people found out about your a cappella group, Mad Harmony, but you will bounce back. I mean, you're the guy always helping people find coverage options with the Name Your Price tool. It should be you giving me the pep talk. Now get out there, hit that high note, and take Mad Harmony all the way to nationals this year! Sorry, it was pitchy.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
I'm Jeff Alvin, the Big Game Hunter, and you are listening to No BS Job Search Advice Radio, episode 1276. And welcome. On this show, I answer one of those classic interview questions that people used to ask me with some regularity. Is it really easier to find a job when I have a new, when I already have a job? Hope you find this helpful. Hope I finally put this to bed. And I hope you subscribe to my channel on YouTube as well. You can do that at jobsearchtv.com. I have thousands of videos there that can help you. In addition, take my classes on Skillshare. Take my classes on Skillshare. And if you decide to join and take my classes and the thousands of other people who offer up quality classes on Skillshare, you can get 2 months for free if you use the link in the show notes instead of the one that the site charges, or that the site offers, I should say. In addition, I've got even more at my website, which is thebiggamehunter.us. Come over to the site, go exploring in the blog. We're doing a site redesign now. It's going to be looking differently in a few weeks. And in the meantime, let's get going.
Is it really easier to find a new job when you have a job? Great question. And it really challenges one of the beliefs of the job search system, both from an employer perspective and from a job hunter perspective. So let me pause for a second, which is what I did before I started recording, but and answer the question. The answer to me is no. And I know that's a surprise because it's a great assumption of job hunting that you need to have a job to find a job, and it's easier that way. But let me dissect it. If you don't have the skills to do a job, well, whether you're working or not, you're not going to get hired. If you have the skills and aren't working, you can find a job. And the same is obviously true if you are working. The real issue is around the negotiation phase. Now, in certain markets, at certain times, the issue may be, why were you fired and not the person two desks over from you? And employers start to think, well, maybe this person was the least productive individual versus the least political individual, or the one with the least seniority. Seniority is always an easy way to cop to an explanation as to why you were the one chosen during particular down markets. But in average to good markets, where the difference is in the negotiation phase. See, employers think that they can get a bargain if you're out of work because you're desperate. That's their thinking. You're desperate. You need a job. You want a job. You'll take almost anything to get back to work. And the longer you're out of work, the more likely you are to behave that way, right? After all, you've been out of work for 6 months. You're only collecting unemployment insurance or whatever the social program is in the country of your choice that you reside in. And they feel as though they can get you inexpensively, which makes you, in some respects, more attractive. But in other respects, it's harder on you because you have to compromise more. Your ego's at stake. And it's hard to say to someone, we want you to start this new position, and we think you're terrific, we think you're wonderful, and we're going to pay you less than what you were previously earning. So on the subconscious level for the individual, you know, they're shocked. And they find it difficult to say yes. So being out of work adds a layer of complexity to the search. You have less wiggle room on the negotiation because firms often will make the job offer say, we're going to give you two choices, leave it or take it, your choice. we don't really care because there's another 15 people at our door who want this job if you don't want it. So, you know, that's the real issue there, where you can bargain, where you can negotiate if the numbers are off. And in other climates, it's how you are perceived as someone who was chosen to be out of work, you know, why that was, and their concern about you. And one of the little trick questions they'll ask under those conditions is, so where have you had interviews so far? Where else are you pending? And if you say, nowhere, well, then their reaction is to go, okay, you know, we can make them a lowball offer because, you know, she doesn't really have any choices. So, and one of the other things that causes them to, and I remember when I first started as a recruiter, I interviewed this one person. It was like my second week on the job, and I was trained to ask the question, so where have you been on interviews before? And the guy reads off a list of 20 places that he's been to that have all turned him down. And, you know, there's a message in that too. So just recognize that the impact of being laid off, the impact of being out of work can adversely affect you very easily. If you are working, it takes away a whole layer of complexity to the situation that puts you on a more even playing field, particularly during negotiation.
So that's today's show. I hope you found it helpful. And if you did, here are a few ways to get even more from me. First of all, visit my website, www.thebiggamehunter.us. I have several thousand blog posts there that you can watch, listen to, or read to help you find your next job. If you want the best of my advice, join jobsearchcoachinghq.com, where I've curated my information with a focus on interviewing. If you have a few questions, contact me through the Magnifi app for iOS. That's Magnifi with an I at the end. Or prestoexperts.com, where you can call me. Schedule a specific time with me through chat on Magnifi or by connecting with me on LinkedIn at linkedin.com/IN/TheBigGameHunter. Once we're connected on LinkedIn, you can message me about coaching you, speaking with me about a resume or LinkedIn profile critique, help with a salary negotiation, my trusted advisor services, as well as scheduling me through for Magnifi or for prestoexperts.com. Like you, I don't work for free. You can also take my classes on Skillshare and become a premium member using the link in the show notes and receive 2 months for free instead of just the one that the site offers. Skillshare offers thousands of courses, not just simply mine. It is a great resource in a variety of different areas. Subscribe to my other podcast, which is called Job Search Radio. This one is number one in Apple Podcasts. Job Search Radio is number two. Subscribe to both. You will get great information 7 days a week from this show, 6 days a week from the other. Lastly, I want to encourage you to join my group on Facebook called Career Angles. It's free to the first 500 people who join and is focused on helping you do better at work. Information is shared daily, and we're building a supportive group there to provide advice and counsel during difficult times. Again, the group on Facebook is called Career Angles. I'll be back tomorrow with more. In the meantime, have a great day. Be great!
Point out the colors of you, I see them too, and boy, I like them, I like them, I like them. We're way too fly to partake in all this hate, we out here vibing, we vibing, we vibing.
Alexa, play Ariana Grande.
Okay.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.
My heart skips skipping a beat, you're not close enough, so that space between you and me, let's lose it. The way you're dancing, swaying to the music, girl, that body and how you move it. Every time you cross my mind, girl, I lose it.
Alexa, play the Country Heat playlist.
Okay.
I don't think you know what you're doing to me, you got my
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.